In this video, we're just going to talk about the composite functions. So simply, composite functions, a composite function is a function of a function, as you can see. Okay, so I believe we understand what it means when you say the function of a 2. Function of 2 implies at every point where you have x in the function of f of x, you put a 2. So in that case, it will be 2 squared minus 3, wherever is x again, I'll put a 2. That's what it means. Okay? Now, when you say f of g of x, this is a function of a function. So what it means is, we can write it in this way. We are dealing with a function f of x. Now, wherever is x, we are putting what? G of x. That's the interpretation. The moment you understand that, it becomes easy. Okay? So at every point in the first function that is written first, in this case we have f of x, at every point we're going to put what? G of x, just like we had done when we had a 2. So do the same. So where is x here? We're going to put g of x. So we have g of x. Now g of x is what? G of x is squared. Where is, again, we have minus 3. Where is x again? I'm going to put what? G of x. That's the interpretation that is there. So now we can substitute. G of x is 2x plus 1. We'll substitute. So I have 2x plus 1 squared minus 3. Where there's g of x again, we're putting 2x plus 1. The moment you just understand that, composite functions are very easy. Consider the first function, the other part, substitute in the function. Okay. So at this point, 2x plus 1, the power 2, implies you have 2x plus 1. Multiplying by 2x plus 1. Okay, so I can expand that. 2x times 2x, you have 4x squared. 2x times 1, you have 2x. You can go to 1 now. 1 times 2x is 2x. 1 times 1 is 1. So you end up having 4x squared. 2x plus 2x is 4x plus 1. Now you can simplify that by multiplying by 3. 2x minus 3 multiplied by negative 3 is going to be minus 6x. And then negative 3 times positive 1 is a minus 3. Okay, we can still simplify it. We have like terms. So 4x minus 6x are like terms. 1 and minus 3 are like terms. So we have 4x squared. 4x minus 6x is minus 2x. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So basically, that's a simplified form of the composite function number 1. Okay, we've done number one. Feel free to pause the video and try to simplify the second one. So our second part of the question, just made a little correction there. Okay, so how basically do we get to answer such a question? So in this case, the first function that is written is the g inverse. Okay, so it means that we need to have an inverse of g there. Okay, that's our original function that we're going to work with. So if you don't know how to find the inverse, don't worry, we'll still talk about it, because we need to find it. So we need to find the inverse of g of x. So what we do is, where is our g of x, to put a y, and then we get it to 2x plus 1. So all we just have to do is make x a subject. So quickly, we get to add the additive inverse of 1 both sides. So subtract by 1 both sides. You remain with 2x other side. Divide by 2. So we end up with y minus 1 over 2 is equal to x. Okay, so by the way we get to under mathematics, we usually put x on what? On the left-hand side. So we can have x on the left-hand side there. Okay, so after you reach this point where you've made x a subject, you can take it in the normal form. Where there's x, put back the x. And on the left, where there's x, put the g of g negative of x. Okay, where there's y, we'll put x. So that one becomes the inverse of a function. Okay, so we found the inverse of our function, g of x. So the question is starting with g minus, that is our first function. So what it means is, in the first function that is listed, at the point where we have x, we'd have to put the f of x. So this is what we have. That is the same, can be written as g inverse of x, g inverse, g inverse of x. Now at every point where we have x, would have to put what? F of x. That's what it means. Okay? So we can quickly go ahead. So in our g of inverse function, we have x minus 1. So where there is x, we are going to put f of x minus 1 divided by what? 2. So what is our f of x? Quickly substitute. Our f of x is x squared minus 3x, according to the question. And then we have minus 1 over 2. Can you simplify this function further? You can't. So there are some cases where the question can even have like g inverse f of maybe 2 there. What that means is where there's x now, you can end up putting 2, and then you get to simplify the question. But basically, this is an introduction to composite functions.